Hello and welcome back to Mary Shuttle. My name is Abi Isong. Welcome back to my channel. And I want to say a very big thank you for everything you guys have done for me. If you're new, welcome to this channel. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below and hit the notification bell so you get notified whenever I put up a new video. If you're an old subscriber, welcome back. For my new subscribers, I give you a hearty welcome to Mary Shuttle. Okay, so this channel is all about immigration to Canada, Australia, Europe, and many more countries. And it's also about schooling abroad and having vacations. So if you like any of these contents, or if you're interested in any of these contents, stay tuned to this channel and I promise to keep you posted. So let's get into today's video. See you. Okay, so today I'm going to talk about Guelph University, and this university is one of Canada's best comprehensive university. It's located at 50 Stone Road E, Guelph, Ontario, Canada. Now, for you to be able to apply to Guelph University, you have to go through the courses that are offered. If good teaching, research, and outstanding facility is what you're looking for, Guelph has got you covered. Now, for you to be eligible to apply to Guelph, if you're doing a master's program with Guelph University, they run graduate programs, they run undergrad programs, and they also run doctorate programs. Now, for you to be eligible for the graduate programs, that's master's, you have to go through a ranking score system. You're going to have a grade score of at least 70% or the equivalent of 70% and above for you to be eligible for the master's at Guelph University. And then for you to be eligible for the doctorate program at Guelph University, you are going to need an equivalent grade score of a B as the minimum, and anywhere from B and above, that is what is going to give you a good grading score. The International Credential Evaluation Guidelines that is developed with in collaboration with the Ontario University Authority, OURA, and then UK National Registration Information Centre is also another evaluation body for Guelph. Now, please take note, WES, that's WES, or Canadian Evaluation System is not accepted by Guelph University. So IECE or WES is not accepted by Guelph University. You need to go through either by sending them your transcript, or you send it to, you do that with OURA or NARIC, that is the one for UK. That is that for you to apply to Guelph. There are certain documents that are required, and these documents are, you're going to be needing two referees, and these referees, you have to let them know that you're using them as referees so that they are alert and they know what to expect, so that they can reply if they are called on as well, because they will call sometimes and then they will send a mail or something and they need to reply from those references. So don't just put up anybody that you feel should be there and then you don't let the person know, so as not to defer or distort your application. You also need your transcript, your statement of research. If you're doing your doctorate, you're going to need a statement of research. Now for just masters, you need your transcript. You also need a CV, or a resume, assuming maybe your BSc is in a different field and then you want to study a master's in a totally different field, but for them to accept you, you should at least have a work experience on that particular field for some years. So that's why they're going to be needing your resume, if that is the case. After you've done that, if there's any other specific documents which differs from the different courses that you're applying to, so if there's any other specific documents that will be needed, they will also let you know, and they'll send you a mail and let you know the specific documents that you can send to them for them to complete your application. Application is done online and mostly for MSc programs. The cost of application is $110 Canadian as of when this video is dropping. So it may change, it may not, but as of when this video is dropping, it's $110 Canadian. That is for masters. And then if you are doing MBA, Masters in Business Administration, or MA, then it is going to cost $150 Canadian. So that is for your application fees. Some courses can differ in price, so take note about that. It's just most of them have the $110 Canadian mark, while some can be higher or lower. It all depends on the course that you are offering. Then after you have paid your application fees, you can then upload your documents, and all your documents, you have to convert them to PDF before you upload those documents. You can also apply for more than one program at a time, but take note, you have to pay for each program that you are applying for. So if you decide to choose maybe two or more programs that you want to offer in Guelph University, then you have to pay the amount, like you pay for program B, you pay for program A, and then you pay for program C. That's if you're offering three different programs. Otherwise, you can just apply for one, and then if you get it, that's a good go for you. So if you're applying for more than one, you're going to pay for application fees for those, the amount of applications you are trying to make. And then if you are for uploading of documents, you're going to be uploading for as multiple choice of courses that you have decided to take. As if you're taking different programs, you're going to upload the required documents for those programs separately. If you uploaded your transcript for one, you're going to upload the transcript for the second one. I hope that is understood. So if you are a little bit confused, please drop your questions in the comment section down below, and I'm sure I'll get a response back to you. Okay, if you're not from an English speaking country or English is not your first language, you're going to be needing a proof of English. And for this proof of English, you can either use IELTS or Duolingo. For now, Duolingo is accepted for those countries that are affected by the COVID, whereby you are not able to take any of these tests except for Duolingo. So it's just a temporary test of English, is not permanent. So Duolingo is accepted for now, as of when this video is dropping. After now, they might decide to change it or not, but for now, because of the COVID situation, Duolingo is accepted by Guelph University. Then you can take IELTS. TOEFL is also accepted. Canadian Academic English Language Test is also accepted. The University of Guelph English Language certificate is also accepted. The advanced level certificate is also accepted. Now, moving on, the tuition starts from anywhere around 6,838 Canadian dollars to 14,000 Canadian dollars. So you have to have that money in your account or paid to the school. Once you started your application, they are going to ask for fees to be paid. You can either pay half first when you are doing the application, and then they will give you a deadline of when to pay the second half. So for now, the fees ranges from for different programs that you want to take, and it starts from somewhere around 6,840 Canadian dollars to 14,000 Canadian dollars. And then you also need to be paying a student fee of 806.48 Canadian dollars. 806.48 Canadian dollars, which is one of the fees you're going to be paying. And you also pay your health insurance. This is very, very important. Insurance, once you are done applying for your school, just apply immediately for your health insurance through the school. And that is going to cost you, for Guelph University, is going to cost you 212 Canadian dollars. My previous video, I talked about designated learning institute, and you'll be glad to know that Guelph University is one of the designated learning institute. So it's a university that can help you get your study visa and also a work permit. You're done applying. If you applied for the fall session, you're going to be receiving a welcome mail sometime in June. And then if you applied for the winter session, you're going to be receiving your mail sometime in December to get you prepared. Then orientation starts from late August through September. So as of this year, 2020, orientation is starting the last week of August, and is going to last through the first week of September. So that is what you have to put in mind, and I wish you all the luck when attending Guelph University. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. If you want, for my next video, I'm going to be talking about other universities as well. If there's any university that you want to look into, you can drop it in the comment section and I'll get in touch with you. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.